Well, it started off when I first moved up here. My family had financial issues and I really was interested in Asian things. And because the financial issues in my life, I wanted to find some that I could put time into so I don't have to think about it.
Before, I was a really shy person. I used to just keep to myself and just not bother with anything.
One of my friends told me about it when he went through it once, so I decided to go through it. And I thought that it would help my anxiety, so I was like, yeah, I'll do it.
I think one of the fundamental things about any kind of program like that is the kid has to want to do it and know what they're getting into from the beginning. We try to do an initial interview to make sure the kids know what they're getting into, know what kind of things they're doing, and find out how excited they are about it. And I think that's most of it, right? The kid decides to do the program because they want to do it.
This is really groundbreaking. The reason it's groundbreaking here in Haliburton is because it's not being done within a mental health agency. It's being done in partnership with the mental health agency, but it's being done and delivered in the school.
I find shadow boxing is just a way to occupy the time. But honestly, the meditation is the big part that actually calms you down. And it teaches you how to be able to be physical and not get all hyped up and aggressive.
So we start with what mindfulness is. We try to give them this idea that they can change. So we have a lesson called Everything Changes. And the lesson really comes down to the only thing that doesn't change is the fact that everything changes. They can change for the better, they can change for the worse, and just trying to instill that they have some ability to direct that change.
I think people actually get it majorly wrong, because I have actually heard a couple people saying that they're teaching other people how to fight in the school through MMA, and I was like, no, they're teaching us how to be mindful in MMA and how to defend ourselves against people who fight.
The martial arts, while it might look like it's about combative, kind of how to be aggressive, etc., I think is really about how to control your body with your mind, how to concentrate, how to have that sense of self. And certainly, I think that one of the things the literature would show is that people that have an ability to be involved in a sport or a martial arts or something, that's something that helps give them resilience.
The yoga that we do, it's nice because it just relaxes you. That's what I find. The yoga just relaxes you, the meditation relaxes you, and then the martial arts part of it, it teaches you to go from all of a sudden stiff to soften completely.
You hear from parents how they've changed. You hear from their teachers how they've changed. A couple teachers come up and they go, is so-and-so in MMA? I'm like, yeah. I was wondering what was happening. Suddenly I was thinking, this kid's better, but then I realized maybe there's a reason for it.
We had a female student that had several situations, and she was always living in her head, so no matter what the situation, she could make it bigger with her thoughts. But for her, she would freeze. So she couldn't come to school, she wouldn't participate in things, she couldn't get to class. But through the semester and doing the mindful martial arts, she began to overcome that.
At first I thought it was just a normal karate class, and then I realized that it's gonna actually help me participate and calm down in classes and that. If I have a problem, mostly my mindful self-talk would be let it go. And then if I can't let it go, then I just try to go to breathing, and if that doesn't help, I ask for help.
Nothing's about getting rid of it, right? If you're angry, anger's natural. You're gonna probably continue to be angry. And if you're uncomfortable or anxious, you probably continue to be uncomfortable and anxious. But it's being with those emotions and doing things anyways if they're important to us.
If something challenging comes my way, sometimes I don't know how to handle it. I don't know how to jump over the obstacle. And with this program, it's helped a lot.
Because if there's less people who are really aggressive, will be less frustration for the rest of the students. And less frustration equals less stress, which means less people will want to drop out of school and whatnot.
Well, there was one thing. It was just after one of my classes. I don't remember which class, but anyway, so I walked out and these people were making fun of somebody. So I told them to stop and they were just yelling at me. And my reaction was, okay, just take all this. It doesn't really matter. And so they kept yelling at me and then they threw the punch. And I was actually, my nerves were calmed down. So I actually reacted in a calm, civilly manner by blocking the punch, grabbing his arm and pulling it up behind him. So went around him and all that, and because he was fighting with his anger. And really, anger slows you down. So I actually helped out somebody and nobody got hurt.
I recently had an opportunity to read the results of the formal study that was completed with Center of Excellence, Ontario Center of Excellence funding. And one of the statements that really stood out for me was a student that described themselves as making friends, feeling human, feeling that they were finally part of the human race because they were being treated in a way that they hadn't been treated before, and because they were finding that through this program, they were actually making friends.
I just want to thank everyone that helped start this program, and I also want to thank everyone who is watching this for paying attention, and also just recommend this to anyone who has troubles in their life. It really does help tremendously.